Hi, this is Jay Valento, live from redwagonteam.com. Today we're talking about Temecula homes for sale. And what we're going to do is we're going to compare Temecula home sales to Murrieta to give you kind of a comparison in sales prices in 2021. Because, well, it's 2022 now, but if you can look at both cities, then you can decide which city would be best for you. On our website, you'd find Temecula homes for sale, and you can look at all the listings in this little table of contents. It's really cool. So you hit show, and it'll show you all the headings of the outline of the page. And you'll be able to look at, for example, Temecula homes for sale down here, and you can adjust the search and look at current properties for sale. But let's look at the statistics to see what sold to give you some indication of a trend in Temecula real estate and Murrieta. I decided to compare the two, see how that would work today. And so the average selling price for a single family home in Temecula versus Murrieta. So Temecula is going to be in blue, Murrieta is going to be in red. So in December 2021, the average selling price in Temecula was $763,145. That's up 26.2% from a year ago at this time. Buy a house. It's best time to go now. If you're selling, best time to sell now. There's limited supply. Prices are going up. I would like a normal real estate market. We'll talk about that in just a minute, what that really looks like. Murrieta's average selling price is $664,536. That's up 24.6%, just a little bit behind Temecula. Let's look at how many houses sold in 2021. So in Temecula, there was 2,257. In Murrieta, there was 2,445, so more homes sold in Murrieta than Temecula. Good for the Murrieta people. Okay, let's look at how long did it take for a house to sell in these two cities. The average days on market, that means the time it was listed to the time they got an accepted offer. So for Temecula, it's 16 days. For Murrieta, it's 17 days. Wow, it's selling pretty quick. Let's look at months of supply. It's kind of silly, but they put a normal real estate market is 3 months of supply. So in 2019, that's a normal real estate market. 2020, it dropped during the first year of the pandemic. 2021, we're now at 1.1 months of supply. That means there's limited number of homes for sale. Trying to get my little fingers online here. There's a limited number of homes for sale, and that's really what's driving the market. There's a lot of demand for property. People are buying. The average price per square foot in Temecula is $307 per square foot. In Murrieta, it's $266 per square foot. So you might get a better buy in Murrieta over Temecula. So you want to compare those two cities. You can do that on our website at redwagonteam.com. And then I find out of all these statistics here, the most interesting one is this one here, the percentage of last listed price. This tells you and I how motivated people are, or are buyers paying more than the listed price. So let's look at the percentage of the last listed price. I always take averages. So 100% would be full price. 102.5% means a buyer is paying 2.5% over the listed price in Temecula and 2.8% over the listed price in Murrieta. Keep that in mind, because when you're out looking at homes, there might be multiple offers. And you have to kind of craft your offer in a proper way. I like to build rapport with the listing agent. That's how I got the last one accepted. Built a lot of rapport with them. There were a whole bunch of offers. And thank God they took my client's offer over everybody else. And I'm really excited for my client. So you can go to redwagonteam.com. I have pages on the website for Temecula and Murrieta. And I have somebody stationed in Temecula that can show you a property or list your property for sale. and I look forward to talking to you soon. You can call me at 562-413-7655. Take care.